This morning, countries around the world are marking 1 year since Russia invaded Ukraine. There you see the Eiffel Tower's lights in Ukraine's national colors.
Tens of thousands losing their lives and millions displaced by the fighting and destruction. George.
And we are joined now by the Foreign Minister of Ukraine, Dmytro Kubela. Thank you for joining us this morning, Mr. Minister. And what a year this has been for you and your people. How has Ukraine been able to prevail against this overwhelming Russian force?
Well, because we dropped fear. We decided that if we attacked, was not our choice, but if you are attacked, you have to fight. You have to take up the fight and defend your country. And this is the feeling that drives us through all of these endless sufferings.
And your president said you're going to fight till victory, but what does victory mean at this point?
It's very simple. It's restoring Ukraine's territorial integrity. I don't think there is any nation in the world that would agree to give away even a square meter of its territory, and Ukrainians will not do that either.
What will it take to push Russia completely out of Ukraine?
I don't want you to get me wrong, but whatever it takes, this is the answer. This is not this war has no timeline. It has only result in the end, and that's victory, because we stand for the right cause. We defend ourselves. We are liberating our territory with generous support of many countries of the world, with the United States being at the top of it. And by the way, first of all, I want to convey the words of gratitude from the people of Ukraine to the people of America for standing by us in this very just struggle for freedom and peace.
It is a just struggle, but it is also a difficult struggle right now. We've learned this morning that Russia is basically in control of Bakhmut, even though they haven't formally taken it over at this point. What more do you need to prevail?
Ammunition, tanks, long-range missiles, planes. These are the most wanted weapons on the list. I have no doubts that we will prevail. President Biden, many other leaders of the world have no doubts that Ukraine will win. But, you know, for David to be able to defeat Goliath, David needs a sling. And all of these weapons, it's all about this sling that will help us to win.
And the president, your president, just said that Ukraine has received Leopard tanks from Poland, but we're also seeing new reports. We heard the Secretary of State earlier this morning that China may be considering providing arms to Russia. What would that mean?
That would mean that China takes a completely wrong side and undermines its own foreign policy, because it's foreign policy based on the idea of territorial integrity, and that's exactly what Ukraine is fighting for. We are following closely developments. We do not have facts in our hands as of now. But we are in dialogue with China to make sure that they remain committed to their own principles.
They've come out with a ceasefire proposal. We heard what the Secretary of State had to say about that. Do you think it's a serious proposal?
Definitely. They tried to make a difference, but from their side. But yesterday, the United Nations General Assembly voted a resolution based on the peace formula proposed by President Zelensky. 141 nations, which is a vast majority of nations from all over the world, Africa, Latin America, Asia, North America and Europe, they all supported a certain vision for the peace. And every other peace proposal has to be based on what United Nations supported yesterday. So now we're examining how much the Chinese proposal is aligned with that.
Vladimir Putin doesn't seem to care about what 140 other nations think, what the United Nations think. He seems prepared to fight to the finish here as well. Is there any kind of a peace proposal that can be acceptable to both President Zelensky and the Ukrainian people and Vladimir Putin?
As of now, we are irreconcilable, because while we defend our territory, he wants to grab our territory. While we want accountability for numerous atrocities committed by the Russian army in Ukraine, Putin wants to escape responsibility. This is a war where one side is black and another side is white. There is no better example. This aggression of Russia will go down in textbooks as the most apparent case of aggression in modern history. So the truth is on our side, and this is why we feel so empowered to fight and to win.
Mr. Minister, thank you for joining us this morning. Michael?
All right, thank you, George. And tonight, World News Tonight anchor David Muir has a new interview with President Biden at the White House.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here. To get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime, we thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.